Foreign Affairs Minister Winston Peters has raised eyebrows after wading into a messy dispute between Canada and India. The diplomatic row over the killing of a Sikh leader in Vancouver last year has caused a serious rift. Mr. Peters wrapped up trade talks in India yesterday, but left behind headlines that could cause issues with some of our closest allies. Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman explains.
Winston Peters with India's Vice President, hoping to take our two-way relationship to the next level. His three-day jam-packed schedule also included his foreign counterpart popping into the cricket, the polo ground and even a local temple. But it was Peters' comments on a diplomatic dispute between India and Canada that made local headlines.
New Zealand ke upa pradhan mantri Winston Peters ne ek akhbar
ko... Winston Peters reportedly saying, "Where's the evidence?" Questioning Five Eyes intelligence out of Canada, which allegedly ties the killing of a Sikh leader in Vancouver last year to the Indian government.
Any involvement of a foreign government in the killing of a Canadian citizen on Canadian soil is an unacceptable violation of our sovereignty.
Canada's Sikh community considered Hardeep Nijjar as a leader of a peaceful separatist movement. The Indian government designated him a terrorist, but denies any role in his killing. A spokesperson for Winston Peters said the minister's point is that this is an ongoing criminal investigation. It needs to run its course before clear conclusions can be drawn.
Canada may view that as New Zealand casting doubt on their claims that India was involved.
Look, I just think the minister was articulating there's a criminal investigation ongoing. It's important it runs its course before any conclusions are drawn.
I don't think it's necessarily a move in substantive terms, but it may be a difference of emphasis which is partly intended to appeal to his hosts in India.
The new coalition government has ramped up efforts to secure a free trade deal with India, sending diplomatic schmoozing into overdrive.
And we are very determined. We want to build a stronger relationship.
But the foreign minister's comments have upset some back home. Matt Robson acts as legal counsel for New Zealand's Sikh community,
who are extremely worried about this free pass that's been, as they see it, given to the Modi government to keep carrying on the type of repression abroad that it has become well known for.
The challenges of diplomacy drawing out plenty of competing interests for our foreign minister.
Yes, a tricky situation for Winston Peters, Mikey. What's at play here?
Kia ora tātou. Well, look, this issue extends beyond just Canada. US officials have made similar claims against the Indian government over what they say was a failed assassination plot against a Sikh leader on US soil. And remember, these are two of New Zealand's Five Eyes partners, the US and Canada, two of our closest allies. And usually when it comes to such contentious issues involving other countries, the best strategy is to simply say less. Now, Winston Peters, he can claim technical innocence over his comments, but of course that will be a tricky one when it comes to how that was received in terms of Canadian counterparts. We understand that Winston Peters was forced to provide reassurances to Canadian officials over New Zealand's position. On the other hand, of course, his comments would likely have been welcomed by Indian officials, and that could work in our favour as we seek to strike up a free trade agreement with India. Now, Todd McClay and Winston Peters as ministers, they have both already visited India. Now, the Prime Minister, Christopher Luxon, he intends to visit India later this year with a large trade delegation. So expect that diplomatic tightrope to be walked once more.
Thanks for the analysis and insight. Kia ora, Mikey.